How many times a week do you think is the ideal number of times you have sex?
Wow, tough.
No pressure lah.
Oh yeah, I feel like you know.
One, two, three.
As many times as possible, right?
Okay, lor. I just worried he not enough army lah.
I think we started since April.
No, I think we started even before that, just not as seriously. We started like November, December.
We got married in October 2010. And actually, we conceived very, very soon after, in December 2010, if I'm not wrong. But we didn't manage to keep the pregnancy.
Actually, immediately after we got married, we started trying already. I wanted one, at least one, before I turned 30. Later, you're too old, you run after your kid, also very chuan.
What are something that you've tried to increase your chances at pregnancy?
All our friends and relatives, oh, you must try this drink, you must try that drink, you must try this mountain, the drink from this mountain, from Japan, from no, don't know where, then your diet must do this, then you must start eating all the poo stuff, you know, red date lah, longan tea.
I heard from some of my friends that once you do it right, you must lift up your legs, like pointing the ceiling for about 10 minutes.
Must prop the pillow, then you must keep your butt up. Then I say, what the heck? This is like doing yoga. Why must hold that position for so long?
I try not to masturbate the day before, so I can have more.
Correct.
Volume.
When my fertile period starts, I ask him to stop.
I mean, it's not like I have a chronic problem. Hey, what do you mean?
I think I took vitamins, yeah. There was this big, big brown bottle and it was quite pricey, but I was like, what the hell? just take it. Then folic acid. They always say take folic acid.
Look, people started recommending me this physician, that physician, like TCM physicians lah. So apparently there's a lot of couples that go and get acupuncture. So you're quite scared lah. Like if you have to poke my wow, then jialat eh, but it's not lah. But they need to like poke her womb. You have to like tell and adjust the whole body.
Yeah.
I tried to eat more oyster, but he doesn't eat oyster. So I thought maybe the guy should learn how to eat oysters.
So at this point, do you think you become more?
A bit. But I love my husband lah.
A bit just... what? You just lie down there.
Hey, I got do a while, okay?
For a while lah. Yeah,
how to get
yeah,
you in the mood. So we know what we are going for. And then we like, okay. Then he will ask me, is today the day? And I'm like, yeah. Is it okay? Yeah. Yeah, wait in the room for me. Like, oh.
Wait in the room.
No, just like traumatization. But quite close to the truth, lah.
Oh. We actually went to a sex shop. Do you remember that?
Oh, yeah.
We just bought like lingerie and things like that.
Mm. Usually, when messages come out faster, remind him already. Hey, I'm gonna chop you this day, this day, this day, this day.
Then she added to calendar, I can see.
I think it's kind of like. Clockwork already, the time reach, okay, now we need to do this and just start whatever we need to do.
Do you think that it would take you this long?
No.
No. We thought,
I feel like
we
the moment when you got married, when you get married, right, the first time you fire your shot, right, you feel like, I'm a daddy already. You know? Yeah. Today is the day.
We thought it was easy.
I think after we went for a fertility test, then we realized we can, then we realized also not very easy. Then, what I learned from the fertility treatment was that I have a B-grade
sperm
quality. I mean, the volume is the same, but the healthy sperm that I have is lesser than healthy men or normal guys. And we found out that she has cysts that's growing in her ovaries.
Chocolate cysts.
So basically, our probability are reduced a little bit. Which I've been told you can still conceive. Like, if I'm not wrong, the doctor himself told me, I also like that. But he got like 2-3 kids lah.
I didn't think it would take me so long to see my firstborn, to hold him in my arms. I think we would try almost every other day. Yeah, we would really like consciously trying. So we lost the first 3 pregnancies actually. And then after the 3rd pregnancy was lost, I was diagnosed with the condition hypothyroidism. I think we went close to 2 years after that of trying and nothing happened after the 3rd loss.
Actually, just 6 months after we got married, I suddenly had this menses cramp. This cramp so bad that I couldn't even stand. So I was just collapsed on the floor. Then I had to try to crawl out to the living room to call him for help. So we rushed down. Then they did a blood test and found out that I had infection. Then eventually I got a surgery, a laparoscopy. to remove 4 cysts. After that, I was told by the doctor to try.
I think that if you haven't been successful, so I really think you should try IUI, IVF, give it a shot, because there's actually a lot of subsidies available for Singaporeans. My first, third and fourth is by IVF. My second one was a very happy surprise.
Yeah.
Actually, we went to this I Love Children talk. It was during then I found out that doing that surgery will affect my egg count. And I wasn't told. Then I told him I was super angry. Why wasn't I told ahead? So it was one of those follow-up. Then I demand to do this AMH test. Then the doctor told me that you actually have egg count much lower than woman your age. So we actually shouldn't wait and we should immediately start IVF.
If you are planning to have a baby, I suggest you start soon if you are already ready to have the baby.
Get checked, very important. I feel like if I didn't know that my sperm quality, or rather the percentage of the normal sperm I have, right, or optimal sperm that I have, if I didn't know it was a low number, I might have dragged this out even more.
Don't Google too much. His favorite line.
Yeah.
Don't read too much, don't Google too much.
You read too much, then you might just scare yourself.
Anything, ask doctor. Don't trust Google.